Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for being with us this morning as we celebrate Carolyn's new life in Christ Jesus. Our order of service for this morning is found in the bulletin that you should have received on the way, and if you did not, please let the ushers know and they can get you a copy. May the Lord bless our time together this morning. We rise and sing our opening hymn. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In holy baptism, Carolyn was clothed with the robe of Christ's righteousness that covered all her sin. St. Paul says, "Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead, by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and mercy, we give thanks for your loving kindness shown to Carolyn and to all your servants, who, having finished their course in faith, now rest from their labors. Grant that we also may be faithful unto death and receive the crown of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Old Testament reading is from the prophet Isaiah, the 43rd chapter. But now thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We join together in speaking together in unison our psalm for today, Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me.
Epistle from Revelation chapter 21. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death will be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore. For the former things have passed away. And he who was seated on the throne said, behold, I am making all things new. Also he said, write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true. And he said to me, it is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give from the spring of the water of life without payment. The one who conquers will have this heritage, and I will be his God, and he will be my son. This is the word of the Lord.
Our responsory for this morning is found in our bulletin. It will be sung responsively between Pastor and I and the congregation, so we'll sing the first line. The congregation will repeat that line. Our responsory is based on Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. There's one for me too here.
Trust in the Lord.
Thank you.
Please rise for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 14th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way to where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. This is the gospel of the Lord." Praise to you, Lord Christ. Please be seated.
Thank you. grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father, and from our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Amen. On June 28th, Carolyn Danowski wed William Schmollinger. The year was, what, 1952? And Carolyn was 30 minutes late to her own wedding. From that day, Carolyn's life is one that was marked by her love for her family. You'll probably not know this, but every time I would visit with your mom, the first thing she would do is talk about her children. She would talk about her family first, what her kids were doing and what their kids were doing, and eventually she'd get to talking about her gardening or what she wished she could be doing with her gardening in later years, and what books she had read. Some of the members of the congregation who know me seem to think of me as kind of like a fountain of useless knowledge and information. I know a little bit about a lot of stuff, and your mom was just amazing in terms of stuff that she absorbed from the stack of books that she always had by her chair in the living room. That same family was gathered around Carolyn June 28th of this year, 70 years to the day later, when she rejoined her husband, William. The last several months of her life were not lived the way that she wanted to live them. Health problems, I'll simply leave it at that, had so drastically limited what she could do. Gardening was not an option. Reading was not as much of a joy as it used to be. But she still loved and cherished her family. And as she went through her struggles, she faced all of them with a quiet confidence. The quiet confidence that I had seen in her throughout her life. The quiet confidence that led a trained nurse to decide, I'm going to be a homemaker. And I'm going to love doing it. No thought of what am I not doing by not being a nurse, but the quiet confidence that I know what the right decision is. That same quiet confidence that I pray you all saw throughout your lives. That example of her certainty and her assuredness. The same kind of certainty and assurance that led her to say, okay, Pastor, you can go. Great seeing you, you can go. Great seeing you too, Carolyn. Let me know next time. Oh, I will. Okay. Through the loss of her husband, through the problems that afflicted her body, especially the last 7 months, she faced all of it with the same quiet confidence. Because Carolyn's faith was firmly grounded in her Lord. She knew who her Lord was. She knew what her Lord had given for her on the tree of the cross. And so she faced all of it with confidence. Confidence in knowing that when we gathered today in this place, and no, she didn't know what day it would have been, because if she would have, she would have told you. But she knew that when we gathered in this place, we weren't gathering to mourn her. Yes, we mourn today. We grieve. But not for Carolyn. For ourselves and for our loss. That you can't sit and talk with her anymore. You can't visit with her anymore. I won't be seeing you drive up with her, Chris, for communion outside the church. Which she started doing when the pandemic came and she wasn't comfortable able to come inside. Because of Carolyn's quiet confidence, her faith in her Lord, her Savior, she knew that today was not a day for us to mourn her. No, today is a day for us to rejoice over her. The promise that Pastor Nick Derline read in Revelation, behold, I am making all things new. Caroline has been made new in Christ Jesus. Carolyn has a new body in Christ Jesus, free from the sickness and the pain that afflicted her in recent years, that allows her to do all that she deeply desires to do. A new body where she dwells in her heavenly home prepared for her by Christ Jesus, her Savior. Reunited with her husband. 70 years after the first day, joined to him in holy matrimony. Reunited to him on that day, 70 years later. And did I hear correctly, about a half an hour before the wedding was supposed to take place? So she made up that 30 minutes she was late. Today, we do not mourn for Carolyn. We do not grieve for her. We do not weep for her. We do that for ourselves and our loss. But for her today, we rejoice and sing. She is made new by her Savior Jesus. Raised to immortality and incorruption, an everlasting life in her eternal home with William, with all the saints who have gone before us, with her Savior Jesus, with our gracious God and Father. And there she awaits. Awaits you and me. Till that day when we join her in that new heaven and that new earth. I've been asked, Pastor, what are we going to do in those new heavens and those new earth? Well, a lot of the same stuff we're doing now. And there are probably gardens there for her to tend. Today is a day to rejoice and sing for Carolyn. She lives in Christ Jesus now, never to die again. Made new by her Savior. And awaiting in that everlasting heavenly home that is there for her, for you, for me. And for all who are made saints in Christ Jesus. Through our own tears and sadness today, we rejoice for her. Because she has been made new. And she now abides forever with Christ. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, guard and keep your hearts and minds through faith in Christ Jesus, who has taken Carolyn to himself and made her new, and has also given you life everlasting. Amen. We join together in singing our next hymn.
Please rise. God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We remain standing for the prayers as we are able. Let us pray to the Lord our God and Father, who raised Jesus from the dead. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and so pass with him through the gate of death and the grave to our joyful resurrection. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant that all who have been nourished by the holy body and blood of your Son may be raised to immortality and incorruption, to be seated with him at your heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give to Carolyn's family and to all who mourn comfort in their grief, and a sure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give courage and faith to the bereaved, that within the communion of your church they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the assurance of a holy and certain hope, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love who have departed in the faith. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and find comfort in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Receive our thanks for Carolyn and for all the blessings you bestowed on her in this earthly life. Bring us at last to our heavenly home, that with her we may see you face to face in the joys of paradise. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O God of all grace, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks that by his death he has destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Strengthen us in the confidence that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Lord, now you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. Mine own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Lord God, our shepherd, you gather the lambs of your flock into the arms of your mercy and bring them home. Comfort us with the certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life and a joyful reunion with those we love who have died in the faith. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. Amen. Let us go forth in peace in the name of the Lord. Amen. If you are able, please join us after our service this morning in the fellowship hall for a brief time to celebrate Carolyn's new life and to support her family. Thank you.